Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and I apologize for the wonky intro here, but this is a game that I started recording, and unfortunately the video driver crashed. And this is something that has been plaguing my Heroes of the Storm installation for quite a while now, ever since I got the GTX 980 back from the RMA. It's not a video card issue this time, it is a video driver issue. Nvidia's aware of it, Blizzard's aware of it, but unfortunately it only afflicts a certain number of GTX 980s, and I'm just one of the lucky ones. So I normally would have just re-recorded, but I had a really good game here. I'm gonna be playing as Brightwing, and we also had a really good team, and I kind of didn't want to let the team I didn't want to let this good team that I had kind of expire, because we were dominating. I don't know if I've actually died or not. Anyway, my computer restarted, and I disconnected, of course. And then I had to rush to get back in the game immediately, which is the reason why I started recording just now. So, apologies for the cold intro, everyone. It's been a good game, and I feel that I wouldn't be doing this team justice if I didn't come back here and show them, because we've actually had a very awesome team composition. Even though my initial reaction to this team comp was not all that stellar because of how weird it is. Here's a team, by the way: Abathur, Kael'thas, Brightwing, Anubarak, and Murky, taking on the Butcher, Zagara, Kerrigan, Brightwing, and Gazlow. Our Kael'thas player was a random player, and then us having the wombo combo of Abathur and Murky in a quick match. You should probably forgive my somewhat skepticism on the on the ins and outs of how well or how not well this match may go, but it's been going quite well. We've been having really good composition. Good chain CC with Kael'thas and myself, and yeah, it's been good so far. Also, I made I'm really sad that I made my last dragon reference to Abathur. I had a really solid play, and saving Abathur, and I made a last dragon reference, which is a reference to a actual spoof movie. It's a martial arts spoof movie called The Last Dragon. Abathur's name is Bruce Leroy, by the way. That's the reason why I'm making that. Yeah, it was a good set of commentary, and it sucks that the video driver thing keeps on happening, and I don't know why, but there's not really much I can do about it until Blizzard and or Nvidia fixes it. So anyway, I am playing Brightwing. Brightwing is someone who I don't really play all that often, but it's mostly because of the fact that I just do not own her. I do consider Brightwing as top tier as far as the supporting role goes. Some people would say that she is even considered what people like to call god tier, meaning that she is a must pick for every game pretty much if she's not banned. And it's debatable. I do like Brightwing. I like the way she plays. I wouldn't necessarily pick her over someone like, say, Malfurion or Rhaegar, but that's just a personal preference of mine. That has nothing to do against Brightwing. But she just sometimes does not match my playstyle, but sometimes she does. When we have a team that has a lot of really good CCers, our Anubarak player and our Kael'thas player have been doing both excellent jobs chaining up the CC. Hopefully I'll be able to give you an example of that now. I'm gonna throw out the polymorph. Oh, Kael'thas just barely missed the gravity last, but that's okay. But all three of us have been really chaining the CC very well. And it's been a truly enjoyable game. Which is not something you would expect from a murky Abathur game in quick match, but hey, just talking about it, man. We're doing good. Also, I want to say thank you to everyone who sent in their warm regards and well wishes for me getting better with my back problem. I also clarified on that, but of course you'll never see that footage because it's lost thanks to the fact that the encoder crashed, thanks to the fact that the video card driver is buggy. So allow me to say again thank you everyone sending in those warm wishes and well wishes and speedy recovery for my back issue. It's nothing, and I truly hope that I didn't give this impression, but if I did, I apologize in advance. I did not. I didn't mean to give the impression that I was under some sort of duress, as far as like, is like an emergency situation. Some people thought that maybe I had gotten into a very bad car accident, or I'm somehow debilitated to the point where I can't walk or anything like that. It's nothing like that. It's just simply a pinched nerve that is causing me a lot of pain and discomfort. But it's certainly nothing that is considered. Expected to be permanent. I didn't mean to. If I worried anyone out there, I truly apologize, and I hope that I did not give that impression that I was having some sort of really terrible physical, like, debilitating issue that was stopping me from walking or anything like that. It's just a pinched nerve that's really causing me a lot of issues. But it's something that is definitely treatable. Luckily, I've been able to finally find some relief thanks to some heat therapy. I've been taking a little bit of over-the-counter anti-inflammatory medication to help with the swelling, that sort of thing, and it's certainly been curbing my my pain a lot, which has been a very big plus. I'll go ahead and teleport on top of. Never mind, doesn't need it. I'm gonna say one of the good moves that I've been doing in this, if I do say so myself, that I've been doing in this game, is that I've been teleporting on top of Kel'Thas or a new Barak, and they've been waiting for me to actually land the teleport before I go and polymorph, and then we land the chain CC, and there's just nothing that the enemy team can do. So definitely big props to everyone on the team here. And again, I apologize for the somewhat wonky start and short notice. For this start, it's not. Again, if this team wasn't as good as they've been, I certainly would not have done it this way. But I think that these players, I do like showing the good and the bad with Soliki Silliness, and these guys and gals, if they are gals, certainly do deserve it because they've been doing an excellent job chaining the CCs and taking down map objectives. I mean, it's 34-4, kind of showing you the magnitude of how well this team has been playing. I did get the Soothing Mist off. That's actually the first time I'm going to die, but I was able to save a new Barak temporarily. Abathur was going in for the Slabathur. Bruce Leroy, the last dragon himself. The baddest man in all the land. Actually, that's show enough, but Bruce Leroy might as well be as well. And those of you who've seen The Last Dragon, you are laughing really hard right now. I don't think Kel'Thas is going to be able to escape. We do have catapults making their way towards the core. If Kel'Thas gets enough mana to get Gravity Lapse, there he goes. Nice gravity lapse there on Gazlo Murky. Should be able to finish it off with slime. And boom goes the dynamite. Boom goes Gazlo. So again, 17 minutes down. I know this video is like missing 10 minutes, and again, I apologize. But I make sure that good players get their due here. Not that I'm a huge channel or anything like that, but I do think it's relevant to show the good and the bad when it comes to Soliki Silliness, and this team has been extraordinarily positive. Very, very good team indeed. If only we could get all of our teams like this. Unfortunately, it's not the case, but hey, it wouldn't be Soliki Silliness without the good and the bad. I'm going to go ahead and teleport on Kel'Thas, and we'll just go ahead and take down the chests. And one more turn in will indeed do it. Let's see. I'm gonna go take down the doubloon chest down, or the doubloon camp down here real quick. Kel'Thas has a total of 6. Murky's got 13. So if Murky turns in, that's gonna be it. And actually, I didn't even need to get the doubloons here, but I'm gonna get them anyway, man. This is my job. I decided that this is gonna be my thing. So we are gonna get the turn in, and that's going to be it. So final total is gonna be 38-7. Even after a little bit of the goofiness at the end there. Still get the game, so get definitely, again, if you see any of these players, tell them that they did a job well done in Soliki Silliness, and that's Invicta and the Mosh Pit. Thanks them for their, not only their positive attitude, but also just fantastic gameplay. We definitely, it's a nice change of pace, for sure. Abathur, I'll save you. No, never mind, I won't. Final total, 40-8. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you had a fantastic start to your day. Again, thank you very much for the warm wishes. I truly hope that I didn't worry any of you out there, and I'll see you next time for more Soliki Silliness. Until then, so long, everybody.